this is Avani Bagga and I am here with our review of the world's first smartphone with four rear cameras, Samsung Galaxy A9. Is it worth the price tag of ₹36,990? Watch the rest of our video to find out.
Alright guys, before we go ahead, do hit the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it so that you see our videos first.
On the first look, Samsung Galaxy A9 will remind you of Samsung's triple camera phone Galaxy A7. But then there are reasonable number of differences between the two. While Galaxy A7 comes with a flat back panel, Samsung Galaxy A9 has a glass back panel that curves towards the edges. Since Samsung Galaxy A9 is a big smartphone, these edges facilitate one-handed usage. The dual-tone gradient glass back panel makes the smartphone look extremely premium. It houses the quad camera setup, which is vertically stacked and has this fingerprint sensor and Samsung branding right below it. The side edges of the smartphone have the volume rocker, power and Bixby buttons. You'll find the SIM tray at the top and a Type-C port, speaker grill and a 3.5mm jack at the bottom. Flip over and you'll see the 6.3-inch display of the smartphone. Unlike most other smartphones that have been launched recently, Samsung Galaxy A9 comes without a notch. And honestly, we don't have any complaints. The bezel at the top and the bottom of the device are equal in size. Above the display are the selfie camera, earpiece and LED flash, and at the bottom are the in-display navigation buttons. Speaking of the display of the smartphone, it comes with a 6.3-inch Full HD Plus Super AMOLED Infinity screen. If we had to describe the display of Samsung Galaxy A9 in one single word, we would call it superb. You will get an excellent contrast and the ability to switch between various screens, including adaptive display, AMOLED cinema, AMOLED photo, and basic. The blue light filter option is there for those who have a tendency of using their smartphones in low light or complete darkness. You can enable it manually or schedule the time for it to be enabled on its own. The display projects extremely vibrant colors while maintaining accuracy, and they remain consistent at different viewing angles. But then, the company is known to make devices with beautiful displays. The images were as sharp and clear as one can expect them to be, and we seriously couldn't put down our phone while we were watching videos on it. We even played 4K content on it and it turned out to be perfect. During our time with Samsung Galaxy A9, we had no trouble with the sunlight readability on the device. Before we start talking about the performance of the smartphone, let's look at the rest of the specifications. Samsung Galaxy A9 is powered by Qualcomm's octa-core Snapdragon 660 processor. Now, this is something not everybody would be too happy with, considering that there are cheaper devices available which come with Snapdragon 845. We understand that the smartphone focuses more on photography and less on speed and power pack performance, but we would have been happier to see Snapdragon 710 instead of Snapdragon 660. Having said that, we should clarify that this does not mean that the performance of Samsung Galaxy A9 was bad. It was good, in fact. But we have used devices with more high-end processors, so we know how much better it could have been. Coming back to the specifications of Samsung Galaxy A9, the smartphone comes with either 6GB or 8GB of RAM and has 128GB of onboard storage. The device runs Android Oreo skinned with Experience UI and is promised to get the update to Android Pie. Samsung Galaxy A9 houses a 3800mAh battery and comes with a fingerprint sensor as well as a face unlock feature. Coming to the software of the smartphone, we would have been happier to see fewer pre-installed apps on the device. In spite of the price tag, Samsung Galaxy A9 comes with apps like Daily Hunt, Amazon, Amazon Prime Video, and others. Speaking of gaming, you may find the smartphone warming up a bit when you play heavy games on it. It cannot be called as a heating issue, but it does warm up a bit, which is something very common with smartphones that have a glass body. But then, as we mentioned earlier, the company is focusing on photography and not power performance with Galaxy A9. If you like to play only simple games like Temple Run 2, it should not be a problem for you. Only heavy gamers would not be as happy as others. The fingerprint sensor of the device was accurate and it worked for us each and every time we tried using it. However, the same cannot be said for the face unlock of the smartphone, as it sometimes did not work too well in dark or dimly lit areas. The 3800mAh battery was decent. It will last you almost an entire day with heavy usage involving games, YouTube videos, playing music and long phone calls. If your usage is moderate, it may last even longer. We observed that gaming on the device does consume the battery quicker than performing other tasks. Now let's talk about the key highlight of Samsung Galaxy A9, its cameras. To recall, the smartphone has a 24-megapixel primary sensor, a 10-megapixel telephoto sensor, an 8-megapixel ultrawide sensor, and a 5-megapixel depth sensor. The company has said that in lowly lit conditions, the smartphone combines data from 4 pixels of primary sensor in order to enhance the quality of the images taken. The modes on the camera app of the smartphone include Panorama, Pro, Beauty, Life Focus, Auto, Scene Optimizer, Super Slow-Mo, AR Emoji, Hyperlapse and Slow Motion. We have to say that we are impressed. The details, the clarity and the color accuracy are as good as one can expect them to be in the given price range. The shots we took in well-lit conditions came out great and we managed to click some really nice ones during our time with the phone. However, at night, the smartphone does take a longer time to focus on the object that is being clicked. We ran a few benchmark tests on the device. It scored 1611 and 5423 in single and multi-core score in Geekbench and 141,420 in AnTuTu. All indicate better than mediocre performance. The pros outweigh the cons here. In terms of design, Samsung Galaxy A9 is an absolute stunner. It has a great display and the photography on the device truly lives up to what the company promised. Samsung could have used a better processor, but even with Snapdragon 660, the performance of the smartphone was smooth. And because the device has been promised to get an Android Pie update, we can't consider Android Oreo as a minus. If you value speed in a smartphone over everything else, you would be happier with a OnePlus 6T. However, if you don't use power-hungry apps on your smartphone and want decent battery backup, Samsung Galaxy A9 makes a good buy. And needless to say, if you're a photography lover, you should just buy the smartphone already.
So that's it for today, guys. If you enjoyed our video, do like it and share it with your friends. We'll be back again soon. Till then, like us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram and subscribe to us on YouTube. This is Avani Bhagat signing off.